not the time. Mankind, that's us, has finally done what it has been threatened into do since it started. That's right, we've blown ourselves to bits. But we're nothing if not resourceful. Since we climbed out of the primeval sludge and took our first glorious steps on this planet of ours, there don't seem to be no mess that we can't get ourselves out of. Just like the words of the old song, dust ourselves down and start over again. Some of the images you are about to see may evoke memories of earlier times. That's no surprise. Any similarity to other eras, fact or fiction, is entirely intentional. Now, two gangs fight for control of a war-torn New York, and only one man stands in their way. Bugsy Malone.
Now, someone once said, it was raining brain, Roxy Robinson wouldn't even get wet. In the whole of New York, they didn't come much dumber than Roxy the Weasel. To be frank, Roxy was a dope. In control, Bronx Charlie. We rule the east side.
Boss, what about me?
Oh yeah, the one in the back, he's Doodle.
Quick, he's making for Fritos.
Shut it, Benny.
He's making for Fritos. Doodle, shoulders, hover the alleyway. Benny, the bed, Yonkers, the sidewalk. Your name Robinson?
Uh-huh.
Roxy Robinson?
Uh-huh.
Also known as Roxy the Weasel?
Uh-huh.
This ain't Roxy the Weasel, the word Fat Sam?
Uh-huh.
Okay, boys, let him have it.
Everyone was playing, sure as X is X, Roxy Robinson had well and truly been scrambled. Now, the lawyer chair here is Flash Frankie, the best lawyer in New York. Sure, he's a little shady, but he's the best, believe you me. Flash Frankie Silvertongue can get a guy to jail quicker than a truckload of dynamite.
Yeah, don't worry. Everything's okay. We'll get a plea bargain with the DA. Yeah, he'll be free as a bird in 6 months, I promise you.
Something kind of fishy's going on here. To be perfectly honest, I'm beginning to wonder what's going on myself. I mean, the play's only just started, and you've seen so many stiffs. Oh, by the way, you're most probably wondering who I am. My name's Malone, Bugsy Malone. what's your name?
Adam.
Adam, I'm Bugsy Malone. Pleased to meet you.
Hello, what's your name?
Danielle, that's a very nice name. I'm Bugsy Malone. Pleased to meet you.
Is anybody else?
I can see someone.
Hello, what's your name?
Daryl.
Daryl, pleased to meet you. I'm Bugsy Malone.
Hello, what's your name?
Adam. That's a very nice name. I'm Bugsy Malone.
Okay, with an Italian mother and an Irish father, I'm actually going up a little confused. I mean, I didn't see much future as a waiter at Mama Lagini's or pushing a pen at City Hall. So I drifted from this to that, you know, walking the line, trying hard not to fall on either side. That is until the night I walk into here.
Hot Beggar's Bookstore. How's it going, Kenny?
Hi.
How you been?
Fine.
Busy. Hi, how you doing? I'm Bugsy.
Gorgeous.
You a singer? A dancer, right? Oh, a baseball player.
Just a lip, Wifey. I'm in no mood for conversation.
You don't like me?
Listen, Wifey, I'm surprised you don't stoop with all that dandruff on your shoulders.
Bugsy, wash and go. You know how it is, lady. If you hear about the audition, you've got a long wait. Lady, all they ever say to you is come back tomorrow.
Who are you?
My name's Fizzy, the greatest tap dancer in the face of this planet.
Honey, you can come in now.
Come on, Fizzy, let's talk to the folks.
All right.
Now, you might be wondering what kind of crazy place this is, with people disappearing into bookcases. Well, firstly, this place ain't for no dumb bums, eh, Fizzy?
No dumb bums at all.
And secondly, this place ain't no bookstore. This is Fat Sam's place. Fat Sam's Grand Slam. Liveliest joint in town. Let's go.
Give me the beat, man.
We spoke. You know, that baseball bat could be classified as a dangerous weapon.
My mother made me pack it.
You're a sports nut?
For protection, in case I get robbed.
You're a singer, right?
That depends on your taste in music. I'm here about a job.
Did you get it?
They said come back tomorrow.
Oh, they always do. What's your name anyway?
Brown.
Brown sounds like a loaf of bread.
Blousy Brown.
Blousy Brown sounds like a stale loaf of bread.
Keep the jokes behind the teeth, Wisey.
Pleased to meet you, Blousy Brown. I'm Bugsy Malone.
Ah!
Come on, let's get out of here quick.
Hey, get out of here, boys.
Ah! Oh, I'm sorry. Calm down, everybody. Calm down, there's nothing
to
worry
about. Where you going, Doodle? Where you going, Doodle? Pick up the gun. Can't forget the gun.
interrupt this program of music to bring you an important news flash. Reports are coming in of a gangland incident on the Lower East Side involving a certain Robert Robinson, known to the police as Roxy the Weasel, believed to be a member of the gang of alleged mobster king, Fat Sam Staccato. Robinson was the victim of a sensational event, and we go over to the reporter on the spot for a...
Nice night. We could walk. Which way are you going?
Which way are you going?
This way.
Then I'm going this way.
Let me carry your bag at least. Have you eaten?
Ever since I was a child.
Then how come you're so skinny, Smarty?
I watch my weight.
Yeah, I do that too when I'm broke. You hungry?
No.
You're not hungry?
No, starving.
Come on. Are you going back to the speakeasy tomorrow?
No, I'm gonna try my luck at the Bijou Theater.
The Lena Morelli show?
She's walked out. They're looking for a replacement.
Oh, she walks out every week, and every week they have auditions, and every week she walks back in again. But don't let me put you off.
You won't. So, what do you do?
Oh, this and that.
Crooked, huh?
No, not quite. I find fighters, boxers. In fact, I was a fighter myself once, pretty good too.
You were?
Sure, I could have been a champion.
You could?
Sure, but for a couple of things.
Like what?
Like jelly legs in a glass jewel.
Some champion.
I know, I know. I do well for a couple of rounds, but I was tough as a ball of cotton wool. This jaw had more glass in it than Macy's windows. One punch was enough to send me back to the dressing room, generally on a stretcher. Bell, slap my face, get out the smelling salts, and I'll come round. Kidding myself, it was a lucky punch. But how many times could it be a lucky punch? Then I wised up, before my face looked like a plate of mashed potato. As Frank Bruno would say,
no, I mean, Harry.
Listen, buddy, in case you're wondering, I am part of the finest chap. I eat eating or are you eating?
Okay, calm down. We'll have two banana boozles, with double ice cream, nuts and chocolate sauce, two cream Arizona donuts, and a Coke with two shorts. We cannot go on meeting like this. Come on.
Good evening, News Desk. The feud between the West Side and the East Side continues in this devastated city. But this time, the East Side have gone too far. As I speak, the fighting continues.
Nel studio de los informaciones. La guerra entre los grupos del oeste y del este está siguiendo en esta ciudad devastada. Pero esta vez el grupo del este ha aumentado la fuerza y ahora están mucho más destructivos. En este momento, como estoy hablando con ustedes, la lucha violenta sigue.
Bonsoir, voici un flash de dernière minute. Des bagarres entre les bandes des quartiers est et des bandes des quartiers est continuent dans une ville qui est maintenant en partie détruite. Mais cette fois-ci, les bandes des quartiers est sont allées trop loin. Au moment où je parle, les combats continuent.
Have a little business to attend to.
I have shown Mr. Brooks, Charlie, and company into the conservatory, sir. But then she got a play no more, honey.
Later, my Rose. Later. Okay, boys, relax. Well, I like to take this opportunity for thinking you work so far. Everything's gone swell. Just swell.
Thanks, boss.
Your lollipop, sir.
Bronx, Yonkers, Benny, Shoulders. Soon, that cell will be crawling his knees to me.
Boss, where's my lollipop?
Soon, all fat Sam will have are the clothes he stands up in and a suitcase full of memories.
Boss, where's my lollipop? I don't have lollipop.
You goof, Doodle. You dropped the gun. And I don't allow mistakes in this outfit, because mistakes can leave us all in a caboose. And Sing Sing ain't my style.
No, boss, please, no. I didn't mean to drop the gun. Honest, I didn't. It just kind of slipped out of my hand. Any guy can make a mistake.
Burn your lip, Doodle. You're all washed up. What is it, Jeffrey?
May I take over now, sir? May I have your exclusive Dandy Dan gun, please? Thank you. And your special edition Dandy Dan bubble gun. Come along now, sir. We have a book all day. And gang membership card, please. Hurry, it is there. Along. I shall now escort you off the premises.
Effective. Very effective. Not my style, but still effective.
Tomorrow never comes. What kind of a fool?
Chicago. A resting place for bums, a trap set in the slums, but I know the score. I won't take no for an answer. I was born to be an answer now. Yeah, that's right, y'all. I was born to be a dancer. Tomorrow, as they say, another working day and another chore. Tomorrow, an awful price to pay. I gave up yesterday, but they still want more. They are bound to come at me to press their way.
Jokes about a poor bus conductor who lived in America and lived in a state which has got the new death penalty, the electric chair. And he was on his bus one day and he asked an old woman for a ticket. She showed him a ticket which was out of date. "You wicked woman," he said. "You can't travel on my bus like that." So he got the woman and tried to get him off the bus and she collapsed and died. So the family took him to court and he was in court and the woman said, the judge said, sorry, "You're guilty, you've got the electric chair." So he went to the chair and the executioner turned the button on and he was still alive. And everyone was amazed. And the bus conductor managed to escape and then he went and worked for another bus company. There was a two children on the side. No, it's a really good joke, really good. The two children at the back, and anyway, he ended up throwing them off the bus and they died. And then he went back to court and the judge said, "You've got 1,000 volts going through this time." And that didn't work. And then he knocked a couple of weeks later, he knocked a man off the bus.
Next!
Maestro.
light, please?
I'm sorry, Mrs. DeVell. I didn't catch that.
I said, can you come into the light? Now, name?
Liza Brown, singer.
What's your high back? I'll give you one more chance. Now come out for good. Hear me or scat? Out, out, out. Okay, honey. Feed it back to Iowa. This show's got its star back. Elena's come home. Hit it, Joe.
Hollywood, here I come, Hollywood. The biggest love you've ever seen in Hollywood. It's so gigantic, just like Atlantic.
Blousy, there's a million other jobs.
Sure, on a street corner with a hat to catch the dimes in.
Cool down, will you, Blousy?
I've been walking the streets of New York for 6 months now, and the only fancy steps I've done so far is avoiding the man who collects the rent.
So it takes time to be a movie star. We always can come back tomorrow.
Come back tomorrow. Come back tomorrow. That's all I ever hear. That's my whole life coming back tomorrow.
Blousy, will you cool down?
I will not cool down. I will not.
Blousy, I'm sorry. There's always Fat Sam's place.
He won't see me.
Sure he will. I'll talk to him.
You know him?
Know him well like this.
Real good friends?
No, not exactly. It's just, when I see him, I cross my fingers he won't hit me. Come on.
We interrupt other news to bring you a further bulletin on developments in the latest outbreak of hoodlum gang warfare. Police now officially state that the new weapon of devious foreign manufacture is being widely used by the mobster gangs. We interrupt our interruption to go straight over to our reporter, Seymour Scoop, who is on the spot at the latest incident.
Have you looked at
it
first, or
did
you have each other?
I'm afraid I can't answer that.
No,
I don't know the answer.
Have you looked at the source?
Source? Sure, I had on my hamburger for lunch.
No, the source for the gun.
Oh, yeah. I'm not at liberty to say. You have to ask Captain Smolsky that question. Captain Smolsky!
Wherever he is. Smolsky? What are you doing?
Seymour Scoop, RTD Radio, Captain Smolsky, can you write? Says we have looked at his scrubs,
don't you? No comment.
Have you looked at his source?
No comment.
Well, is it true the guns are being used by the one gang?
No comment, okay? Get out of here.
I think you're performing right damage.
Oh, well, thank you, Audrey. Okay. You stop right there, okay? Now, we know there are five guys here, but what else do you see?
Nothing.
Yeah, well, you must have seen something.
I didn't see anything. I've just come out and auditioned.
Okay, you can go. Drink, what are you doing?
Captain! I found something.
So what is it?
Oh, a magnifying glass, Captain.
You knuckles, what have you found?
A gun, Captain.
Yeah, but what kind of gun?
A big gun, Captain!
Oh, you knucklehead! I sent you a stick my fingerprint card, and all you can tell me is that it's a big gun. Oh, you need a wrench, dude, but get out of here, you idiot!
Now, as you probably... Hey. Okay, as you probably gathered... Smolsky and O'Dreary have as much chance of solving this case as I've been President of the United States. Apart from the subway, home of the only thing Smolsky ever caught was Asian flu. Meanwhile, back in our story, back, Sam's getting all nervous. I mean, wouldn't you get a little nervous if you had a gang of dumb bums like that to rely on?
Get out of here. Sam's boys were quite a shock.
There you go, Dad.
Good work, shoulders. If there's one thing I can't abide, it's the two-timer canary.
Kidney bees with kidney bees come by for kidney babies.
Come on. 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 Okay, boy, let him have it. Shooting a horse or running a railway station.
Sam ain't gonna like this, honey.
Sam ain't gonna do nothing about it. Without his gang, he's like a tortoise without a shell. Soon, he'll be thrown in the towel.
Practicing?
Yeah, still practicing.
Have you seen Blousy? I thought you was here for an audition.
Blousy? Oh, the strange girl. Yeah, she went outside for a breath of fresh air. She left her jacket, so I guess she's coming back.
Thanks, Fizzy.
Anytime.
Feed it!
Well, you know how it is.
You used to come and see me every night.
I've been busy.
Busy doing what?
This and that.
Busy? Will you cook the ivories and hit the shoe leather?
Yes, ma'am.
You're 80. You know that photo? I've always found you kind of special.
Careful, Palula. You're racing my motor.
Come on. Give a girl a break.
Are you sure you got the right guy?
You're not like all those other fans.
No.
You've got lovely brown eyes.
Yeah, and it'd be lovely black eyes if Fat Sam catched us.
Come on, sugar, how about this marijuana?
Look, Tallulah, I'm warning you. If you come any closer, I have to call my lawyer.
So call him.
Oh, hi, Bugsy. I was looking for you.
Hush your mouth, jerk.
Ready, boss. The broad's ready for our audition.
Okay, honey, I'm on it.
Tickets, but first I had to earn the money driving Sam and Looney. Looney Begone. Boy, when they said he was off his trolley, they weren't kidding.
Quick, Bugsy, here he comes. Are they along?
Yeah, just look like Dan and the driver.
Get over there.
What can I do for you, Sam?
How about a small dose of straight talk, Dan?
Suits me.
You've been taking liberties.
I've been taking what's mine.
The trouble is it belongs to me.
Well, you've been doing a mighty fine job of detective, ain't you, Sam?
Your mother teach you any respect.
Speaking of mothers, I heard a few stories about yours, Sam.
Yeah, like what?
I heard that your mother's so fat, she got baptized in seawater.
Yeah, I've heard a few stories about you, Dan.
Is that so, huh?
When you were young, you weren't always so pretty. Your mother used to put you in the backyard to keep the stray dogs from following you. Didn't it, Dan?
Okay, Sam. Sam, your head is so small, you use a tea bag as a pillow.
Okay. You're so dumb, you... You bought an elevator with a mobile home.
How obtuse.
Wait. Let's talk this over like old-fashioned businessmen like we are.
Speaking of old, your mother's so old, she was a waitress at the Last Supper.
Right, that's it. Looney, let him have it. No, no, he didn't
there. Come on, see where you come from.
Come on, Mr. Gills, get out of here.
Gee, thank Mr. Kiddo.
Get rid of that laundry sack you're wearing. Here's the name of my tailor.
Thanks.
Think nothing of it. My pleasure. Right now, let's get out of here.
Okay.
He's a man, he's a rolling stone.
Hello, Blousy? All around, listen, I can't talk now, but I just earned myself $200.
You mean you printed it yourself?
No, I earned it, swear to God.
You mean what?
Oh, this and that.
Who's
Fat Sam.
Fat Sam gave you $200?
Yes, and the loan of his sedan for the afternoon. Look, you get yourself outside the Grand Slam in, say, 10 minutes. Look for a snazzy sedan with a good-looking driver that has a close resemblance to yours truly, okay?
Okay, but you better not be putting me on, Buster.
I'm on the level. So long.
Hey, Bobby?
I've given up, guys. Enough of your trouble. Believe me. From now on, I'm with my husband. And I ain't getting too attached. I'm gonna change him regular. Like a library book.
Don't you think I look cute? Why do you think of the dress, Grandma?
Well, I don't know.
Oh, come on, what do you think, Dottie?
I don't know, Bangles. Maybe it's just the color.
What are you talking about? Purple's my color. I always wear purple.
It matches the veins in your legs. Well, maybe it's just the lamp.
It's the latest thing. I read in the magazine.
Well, maybe it's the frills. They stick out too much.
They match her ears.
Do you think it'll look any better on you?
Frankly, my dear, it'll look better on a horse.
You're just jealous. Can I help it if my looks are ahead of my time?
They're what?
Full of personality. Character. Kind of earthy.
Yeah, like a bucket of mud.
Breaded sorted or cheese and onion?
Cheese and onion. Do you really have $200?
No. I just bought two chips.
You didn't do anything crooked, did you?
Of course not. I got it for helping Mr. Sam out of a little predicament. Oh, I nearly forgot.
What's this, a finger bowl?
It's for you, a dummy. Look, you look through it, push it down, and you see all the Hollywood stars.
Oh, if only I could get to Hollywood.
But you can.
Sure, I've heard that one before, wise guy. In the front row of the Roxy on East 38th Street.
No, really, get to Hollywood.
What do you mean?
Right, I got $198, right? What does that buy?
440 bags of crisps.
No, two tickets, stupid.
Two tickets?
On the Super Chief.
Super Chief?
The train, dummy. Think about it. I'll be back.
I'm feeling fine. Filled with emotion, stronger than wine. They give me the notion that this strange new feeling is something that you're feeling too. Two tickets?
Yeah, two tickets.
Matter of fact, I'm forced to admit it, caught in the act. Maybe we've hit it. Is this strange new feeling something that you're feeling too?
So what's the answer?
Did you honestly think it would be anything but yes? Oh, Bugsy, Hollywood!
Okay, Blousy, calm down.
You're putting me on?
No, it's just, I gotta get back Fat Sam's car. Come on.
This time, Captain.
I have. Oh, yeah, sure I have. So tell me what you see.
Your foot, Captain.
Not my foot. Under my foot, you knocked their tire marks.
You know, if Sherlock Holmes were alive, you'd put him to shame.
Too bad I would. Go and get some plaster. We'll take him out. But there ought to be more marks. This sure as eggs is eggs. More than one stand around here. So what's this?
Oh, sorry, Captain, I'm really sorry.
Oh, you double it! I cannot believe you, you double clean-faced jerk! When I catch your jing, my foot says, keep it up, but the other side of the Atari. You double it!
Going to work, Bob?
Of course it works. Don't crack your knuckles, it makes me itchy.
course it'll work. It looks good, doesn't it? Doesn't it?
Shaba. Kind of.
Anything Dandy Dan can do, I can do better. Am I right or am I right?
You're right, Ross.
Okay, Knuckles, get ready.
Excuse me, would you mind holding this for me, please? I'm ready, boss.
Get set.
I'm set, boss.
Fire! Missed.
Back to the drawing board, Knuckles.
Knuckles? Oh, poor Knuckles. Speak to me, Knuckles.
What are you gonna do, Mr. Sam?
I don't know, Fizzy. I don't know. It's all your fault, you greasy lounge lizard. I'll get you for this.
As you can see from the mess of things here, things are looking kind of untidy in Fat Sam's life. And, well, as for Knuckles, whatever game it was he was playing, he's sure casting his chips. And as for Captain Smolsky, well, he started out with the intention of chasing O'Dreary back to county court. But he soon found out that he had quick drying plaster poured all over him, and very soon he was stiffer than some of those dudes he occasionally pulled out the East River. Hello, is anybody there? Hello, is anybody there? Get off of me! Hey, come on, what's going on here?
Hey, what are you doing? Leave him alone!
Well, what are you gonna do about it, punk?
I don't hurt you, just leave him alone.
Come on, punk, come on, hit me, man, come on. You're getting my nerves, man, come on. Just get over and done with it, I'll punch you, man, come on.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure, bro, come on.
Take your money, mister?
Yeah, $200, that's 90 cents. It was sure nice of you helping me like that.
Oh, it was nothing.
You must be a boxer, right?
Nope.
But that was the best punch I ever saw.
Oh, it was nothing.
You ever been coached?
Nope.
You ever thought of taking up, I mean, professionally?
Nope.
You haven't?
Never thought about it.
I know someone who could help you. You know KG Joe?
Nope.
You know Sluggers Jim?
Nope.
You don't know much, do you?
Nope.
You must know this. What's your name? Come on.
Smith. Leroy Smith.
Put it there, Leroy Smith. I'm Bugsy Malone. You just got yourself a manager. Come on.
Come on, guys, ain't you ready yet?
Hey, KG Joe!
Hi, Bugsy! How you been, man?
Real swell, real swell. And you?
For me, not too bad. But for this bunch of punchbacks, the pit.
KG Joe, I want you to meet the next heavyweight champion, Leroy. Meet KG Joe. KG Joe, meet Leroy.
You ever been in the ring before, boy?
Nope.
You want to be a fighter, huh?
Nope.
Sure he does. Look at those fists. Did you ever see such fists in your life? Hit it, Leroy. Not so hard.
What'd you say your name was again, kid?
Smith. Leroy Smith.
With you showing him the ropes, KG Joe, he could be champion in no time.
Okay, I'll give him a try. But I'll tell you one thing now, I'll be no good unless it's got it.
It? What's it?
It's the difference between being a no-hoper slugger and being a champion.
So what makes a fighter special? You haven't got it, just haven't got it.
Can you pass the test? I can say you got it in.
you work and you sweat and you bend and you train to a hard song. Then you need to lose your mind when you find that your boy has a class door. But you might as well quit if you haven't got it.
You.
Put your flaps down, Tiger, or she'll take off. I've got a message for you.
So what's wrong with the internet?
Mr. Halpin doesn't seem to think it's cost effective. Come on, let's go before your suspender belt strangles.
I'm sorry, Tallulah, I'm waiting for someone.
You are?
Who?
For Blousey. We're going to Hollywood.
Well, you know what they say. Don't pack anything you can't put on the train home. Listen. Fat Sam's in trouble and he needs your help. I'm sure he'll see you, okay?
Okay, I'll do it. Let's go.
Very droopy, boss.
Here, hold it, man. It needs a little water.
Now don't let me see you laughing at me again. You hear me? I'm Fat Sam, number one, top guy, Mr. Big.
Careful, boss, the floor's wet.
You little good crook, I'll break that mop over your head. Hi, Bugsy.
Oh, hi, Mrs. Staccato. How you been?
A little difficult at the moment. Please call me Sam and take a seat.
Thanks.
To lose the money, fix him a drink.
What's your pressure, Bugsy?
Oh, I'll have a special on the rocks, please, Tallulah.
Bugsy, I'm in a jam. Dandy Dan's breathing down my neck, and anything now, he'll be taking over my entire organization.
But you still got all this.
Not if Dandy Dan gets his way, I won't have a dime for shoe shine.
Nothing?
Not a red cent.
There we go, one special on the rock.
Okay, Tallulah, go fix your makeup. I already fixed it. Then go make yourself more beautiful than you already are.
But you know that...
Tallulah!
Okay, I'm going.
Bugsy. My gang's gone, my friends don't want to know me, my business ain't worth a hill of beans. In short, I need you.
Me, Sam? Why me?
You're not like those other dumb bums. You got brains up here, not pretzels.
No, Sam. Rostov ain't my line.
I'll give you 200 to go with the 200 bucks I already gave you.
Impossible.
I thought you were smart.
Impossible, because I already lost the first 200 you gave me.
You lost 200 bucks? On a horse?
No, I was mugged.
A hoodlum ain't safe walking the streets these days. Here, 200 to go with 200 that you lost.
$400?
Yep. Do we have a deal?
We have a deal.
What are we gonna do?
Hello? Yeah, sure, I'll get it. Bugsy, it's for you. It's lousy.
Oh, I'm coming. 1 minute, Mr. Sam.
Okay, sure, Bugsy. Use the phone all you want. From home, from Europe, phone anywhere. See, if Danny Dan gets his way, he'll be paying the phone bill.
Hello?
Bugsy, is that you? What are you doing there? It's getting dirty and you're an hour late.
Something came up.
Like what?
Like business.
Oh, yeah, with Tallulah?
No, not with Tallulah. Like I said, something came up.
You promised me, Bugsy. You promised me.
Hollywood can wait, okay? This can.
An hour I can wait here, Bugsy. And when I first did the show, I gave you the benefit of the doubt. And I got nervous and called every four-wheel guy in the phone book. They haven't seen you before. Should they all know you?
Get off of me, Tallulah.
You rat.
It's all your fault.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, get baby face.
Get baby face. Is any of your names out there called Babyface? Come on, y'all. One of your names must be called Babyface. What am I talking about? I am Babyface.
Give this to Babyface.
Give this to Babyface. No thanks.
Babyface, get out
there.
Okay.
Gotta have courage. Yeah, I'm the starter's play right now. Just face the star Harry CTC. Geronimo!
Come on, everybody. Look.
Okay, we know you're in there. I'll give you 10 seconds to give yourselves up. Come out with your irons, with your hands up in the air.
What are we gonna do, Bugsy?
I don't know, Leroy.
Okay, this is your last one, and I'm gonna start counting now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Sis, Captain, the next number is 6.
Oh, Jerry, don't you think I can't count my numbers from 0 to 10?
Actually, Captain, 0 is not a number. It is a concept. Ultimately, the complete absence of quantity, i.e. nothing. And you'll find that a number is the amount, count, or sum of a group of things.
You're one strange guy. You know that? I mean, you have the intelligence of a penguin on steroids. Ah, you idiot. So can I stop counting now?
Sure, Captain.
Thank you. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Look, Bugsy, another way out.
Come on, let's go quick.
Okay, don't think I'm bluffing. We'll be coming in, and you'll get what's coming to you. Okay, this is it, Drew.
Whatever you say, Captain.
8, 9, 10. This is it, ready now. Oh, Drew, where did it go?
Somewhere else, Captain.
Oh, you idiot, get out of here.
Well, this is the caper that's going to take the roof of City Hall. This is the big one.
The big one.
The shakedown.
The shakedown.
It's got to be good, it's got to be neat, and it's got to be quick.
Got to be quick, got to be neat.
Quit repeating everything I say. You shouldn't have any trouble. Just salmon a few dance skills. Remember, when you get inside the speakeasy, keep those fingers pumping, because if you hitch, you'll be riding. Has anyone got anything to say?
3 cheers for Danny Dad.
Hip, hip.
All right.
Hip, hip.
All right.
Hip, hip.
All right.
Too kind, guys. Too kind. Now for Fat Sam Grand Slam.
Okay, everybody. Come on. Come on. Get in. Get in. Leroy. Leroy.
Okay, okay.
Babyface. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. You guys make sure you hit him. The rest of you act normal. Girls, off you go. Rap has music. Hit the ivories, Joe. and you're most probably wondering what's happened after all that. Well, as you probably gathered, it was a happy ending.
Fat Sam and Dandy Dan decided to join forces and take over the whole of New York as one big criminal organization.
And Fizzy here finally got his audition and became one of the best dancers Broadway ever saw. Tallulah here took over the speakeasy with her gang, and my good best friend Leroy became the WBO, WBC heavyweight champion of the world, just like I knew he would. Come on. And as for me and Blousy, well, whatever game it was we were playing, we sure went to Hollywood. So really, y'all can go home now. Bye. But as they say, it's not over until the fat lady sings. Hit it, Cassie. No, really, folks, that is it. Thank you for coming. That was Bugsy Malone. Thank you very much.